Yo, what's up, guys? I'm here to do an anime review on the anime Claymore. Now, I started to do a review earlier, and I did it and uploaded it, but it was laggy for the first 2 minutes, and I want to give you guys the best that I can, so I'm probably going to take that down and re-upload this one. But this anime starts out with Teresa, a Claymore. She's labeled Teresa of the Faint Smile because she never fully smiles when she attacks. She's always got a faint smile, basically. So basically what they are, basically what claymores are, they're humans infused with the Yoma, which are basically these demon-like spirits, and they're made to combat the Yoma. But basically what happens if they kill too many Yoma, or like an abundance, or unleash abundance of their power at once that they gain from infusing themselves with the Yoma, then their Yoki auras will take control, and then they'll turn into an awakened being. And the thing is that when you do, or when you're about to turn into an awakened being, you give someone a black card so they can come and kill you. That's the whole deal with it. Now, when it first starts off, Teresa's just going from town to town slaying Yoma. When she saved this one small girl who could sense the fact that basically Teresa wasn't really happy, and I guess she was suffering from loneliness and stuff, so she was basically trying to comfort her after, well, she saved her life anyway, but Claire was basically going to try to comfort her. And then Teresa got a black card to go kill somebody. And Claire didn't really understand it, so she begged her not to. And she did it anyway. And then Teresa left Claire at the next village when she realized, oh shit, that Yoma I killed was the only thing protecting this village from bandits. And when she went back, the whole town was burning, and the bandits taken over. And basically, Claire went in there, or Claire was in there, being taken by the bandits. Now, the whole thing for a claymore is they're never supposed to kill a human. It is taboo. They will die if they kill a human. From the organization that, the organization will kill them. The organization has approximately 47 different claymores in that area, and if you were to kill a human, then they would bring up a squad of claymores to kill you. Basically, what happened is that happened to Teresa. Teresa killed all those people to save Claire. And basically, Teresa was hunted down by the organization and wound up fighting an awakened being with a few other members of the organization through some kind of fight. All right, the organization members that were sent to fight her, one of them fully awakened, and they basically Teresa and the other members that were fighting Teresa alongside with us. Teresa's number was the number one. The number two awakened. They had, I believe it was three, four, and five there with them. So Teresa number one and three, four, and five were to take out Priscilla because she had awakened. And when Teresa was finally about to take her out and Priscilla was begging for her life, Priscilla basically swooped up her sword and chopped off Teresa's arms and head. Now this sent Claire into a state of spiral. And also she Clint Priscilla killed all the other ones except for Elena, which was a proctor of the quick sword, which means she could stab you about 1,000 times before you could even move. And she lost an arm. Elena lost an arm. And Claire was just ignored because apparently she was just too inferior to kill. Now basically, what happened after this was Claire decided that she wanted to take vengeance on Priscilla the Yoma for taking the only thing that she loved. So she went back to the organization, or she found a member of the organization and told her to infuse the Yoma blood from Teresa's body into her. And basically, she's the first. Claire is the first human breed with a claymore. So it's a human claymore Yoma. Well, a claymore. The Claymore has Yoma, so it's a human Claymore hybrid. And she's ranked 47 in the organization, so she kills Yeoman, and she finally, she gets tired of it, and she's like, I want to go ahead and kill Priscilla. Well, the organization wasn't going to straight up send her after Priscilla, because obviously she's a Claymore, she's useful, and also, they just didn't want to send her straight up to her death. So, she was also apparently annoying to him. So they sent her on this mission to go kill an awakened being, her first actual experience to fight awakening being. And prior to this, she had been killing Yoma, and she had also picked up someone who followed her around, basically the same as Teresa did, except this boy's name was Rocky. Rocky's whole goal was to protect and basically save Claire from the life that she was living, just protect her whenever he could. Now, Rocky was left in like a motel or a hotel or whatever you want to fucking call it, an inn. And Claire went out with three or four other decently high ranked members to go kill this awakening being when number eight, Miria, had told her that this was act by the organization to try to get them killed, or at least it was a conspiracy that she didn't know for sure, but that's what she thought. So what happened was they all decided that they were going to work together to try to figure out what is actually going on, but they swore their swords that they wouldn't tell anybody else, that it was just going to be them. Later on, they go to actually step their game up so they can get closer to Priscilla, because that's Claire's whole goal. And they go to the west to fight one of the creatures of the abyss. The creatures of the abyss are the highest ranked members. When they're awakened, they really can't be killed by anybody because nobody's strong enough against them. There are three creatures of the abyss. One went west, one went north, and one went east, I believe. Now they went to the west one, and basically Claire saved the number six of the new time, because it's obviously the new time, it was more Claymores. She saved the number six, and number six indebted her life to her when she was being tortured by the chick in the west to try to turn into a Yoma, because they were trying to harness awakening beings to aid in a fight they were planning or something with Easley of the North, which is another one of the creatures of the abyss. The one in the east hasn't been talked about in the anime, but basically they, after doing fighting with her main subordinate, the West, they almost killed her, but then she stepped in and was like, no, I'm not letting you kill him, but y'all can't escape now. So she let them escape. And then immediately after, the organization assigned them to a mission to head up north to defeat a bunch of Yoma that's been gathered by Easley of the North, which was basically a death mission. They sent about 20 Claymores up there, and Miria, which was the highest ranking, I believe, or numbers. Yeah, Miria, which was the highest ranking there. Well, she saved number nine, actually, not number six. Miria, the highest ranking there, separated them into five platoons to fight off the Yoma. At first, they only sent in three Yoma, and most of those Yoma, all of the Yoma were actually killed with no casualty, and it gave everybody in the battle experience fighting an awakened being. But in the next attack, they had two Yoma and the Lion King of. Well, it's not, you say Lion King like it's like the movie, but no, it's a lion awakened being. So he took the form of a lion. He's still obviously a Yoma with a human breed. There's not an actual lion mixed into it. And he basically kills most of the leaders of the platoons, which are the highest ranking members. And Claire manages to defeat him by awakening only half of her lower body. And slowly, a little bit more, not enough to actually take her back from it, because she's found a way to go into the awakening state and revert back from it. not completely into it, but majority of the way. When they use 10%, their eyes change color. When they use 30%, their veins shoot off the side of their face. She was using probably somewhere around 60% of her power. And she managed to defeat the Lion King, dude, so easily steps in with, not easily, but Priscilla manages to find her way there, but she still sees Teresa and not Claire because Claire is infused with Teresa's soul. And she was scared shitless of Teresa when Teresa was there. And then when they go back to fight, she's like just ripping Claire into pieces. When three of Claire's buddy, Denova, Miria, and one more decided that they were gonna try to help her after she had been beat down. Basically, they all just got destroyed. All right. And obviously Rocky, as earlier he found out that she was awakening because she was using so much and there was nothing he could do. Him and the number nine that she saved were going up the mountain to try to help them out when they seen that she was well above the power she was at earlier, so like 80% probably awakened. And the thing that irritated me so badly was Rocky's gonna jump in the way and stop. After Claire finally got the advantage on Priscilla and was actually about to kill her, Rocky jumped in the way and stopped. It's like, what the fuck? This is what this whole anime was about, to destroy Priscilla and take revenge on Teresa, and then all of a sudden they're just not gonna do it. Now, I mean, it goes on in the manga, I've been told already, so just the anime needs more for it to make logical sense and still be good, because with the sense it makes right now, it's just not that great to me. Well, that part of the story anyway. The rest of it's really good. Well, anyway, she basically manages to revert without going into full awakening mode, and her and Rocky basically continue to live on, being chased by the organization. She asks Rocky if he still wanted to come with him, and he's like, yeah. But overall, character progression, I always expected Rocky to get like Yoma form because he just seemed like the candidate to do that, because his goal was always to save or help Claire, and he never got to do that. So, other than that, Claire was the only actual plot progression. Not plot progression, but character progression. So, overall, character progression ain't good. I forgot what I rated in the last video, but that's gotta be like a 7 out of 10. And animation, it's not that good, but it way it is from 2001 when this originally aired. So, for most times, good animation, I'd probably say 8 out of 10. Plot progression, the plot progressed really well. I would have to say that. Plot progression gets a 9 out of 10. Overall, I give this anime an 8 out of 10. And that's just how I feel about it. Peace, guys.